idea for the marching band started in 2013 when Vicky and Gene Johnson, as well as a lot of other friends and alumni of the university, were at some football games, and they were playing canned music through the speaker, and they just felt really strongly that game days wouldn't be complete without live music. So the Johnsons helped raise the funds to start a drum line that year. And then pretty soon after that, the plans for the marching band started. And Dr. Miller, who was our first band director, and Dr. Smith, who was director of bands at the time, helped recruit for 150 band members to start in 2015. We didn't originally have the Johnson Band Center. It was operating out of what is the old residence dining hall, which is near where Sovie is now. Then we eventually were able to move into our nice, pretty new building, the Johnson Band Center. The highlight for the band, of course, was going to France in 2018, so that was a big deal. It was a pretty special trip. The community and the university really supported the band in making the trip, and it was especially meaningful because UNC Charlotte was founded shortly after World War II to support education for returning veterans, so that linked really well with our trip for the D-Day ceremonies. And now it's been 9 years since the marching band started, and we're still going strong.
My name's Brian Taylor. I grew up in Austin, Texas. I actually know Dr. Kopczynski from our graduate work at Michigan State. And so he had told me that there was going to be an opening here. And I knew a little bit about Charlotte just from him having been here for a year. And it seems like a really exciting place to work. The faculty's all very interested in growing the program. And they're all really hardworking and nice people. So it just seemed like a really fun and energizing place to be. So I'm excited to be part of the faculty and get to know some of them a little bit more after band camp finishes. But yeah, that's basically my story up until this point.
Hey guys, my name is Keenan Boswell.
Chase Miner.
Lily Cagle.
Amanda.
I am the current drum major.
Music librarian.
Program assistant.
One of the captains in our color guard section.
This is my second year being drum major, and it's sadly my last, but I'm looking forward to having a great season and setting us up for some good success.
I'm very honored to be a part of the marching band. It's something that's really important to me. I was really lucky to have been welcomed in with such a lovely community.
I'm actually really excited to meet everybody. We're going to have a really big guard this year, so I'm really excited about it.
My main goal is to bring the energy that I want the band to have, so you're always going to see me being cheerful and happy and bringing 110% so that I can give you guys 110%.
I hope to bring comfort to everyone in the band, make sure that everyone has their music and that they feel prepared on time.
I'm going to say be ready to have some fun and have some laughs. I'm looking forward to all the jokes and the memes that are going to be made this year.
Everything you do matters, even if somebody doesn't see you do something, so just keep your integrity up.
Being a supportive section leader I think is really important, and I think that, you know, inspiring other people to be that way is also very important.
And I was nervous if, like, everybody already, like, met their friend groups and whatnot. And I was welcomed with open arms, and everybody was from all different places. And also with building lifelong friendships as well. There's some people that I just met probably yesterday that I just talked to, that I known of them, but we got to have a better connection last year, 2 years ago, and now I just get to have those memories, and I really appreciate that from all of you.
Yeah, I think going off of that, like, I think as a band we want to promote that, you know, like, we want to present ourselves as, like, you know, you can have these friendships for a long time, and it really is a family, and yeah, I think as an organization, you know, promoting that positive atmosphere. And
I want to add on to that, like, performances that build pride, leadership, and confidence. I think, I think coming into the university, you know, a lot of people, they go to their class and they go back to their dorm, go to the dining hall, go to class. Like, there's not really much more to it. But, like, being in marching band, there is a sense of pride, like something bigger than just class, I guess.
The thing that really gets me excited about teaching marching band is that it's such a large group of people, a big family, large community, that I can't do everything. And so we turn a lot to our leadership to implement the ideas that we've worked on in terms of building community and also creating excellence in our band. To me, that means that they get to introduce their own ideas. They get to come up with stuff, and they get to have successes and some failures. And my job is really just to kind of be there to help them when they have those successes and failures so that they can refine their ideas and think about how to better implement them as we move forward.
2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and stop. Cool. We're going to fill up all the way in 8 counts and get rid of every last bit of air in the out 8 counts. Right now, I'm still seeing some of the breath start up here in your chest. Make sure it starts down. So we want to breathe down. Everything is drawing air down into our bodies. And 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. Okay. Two things that I'm hearing. One, our air is not starting immediately with our tongue, right? I hear ta instead of ta.
So the thing I'm most excited about for the season is just basically seeing what our students do. Because, you know, we set the tone, but they're the ones who actually go out on the field and perform. And so I'm just really excited to see everyone has really risen to the challenges I've put in front of them over band camp. And I think we're going to continue that through the season.
Super hard the last week, getting everything ready for you to come. We've worked on a lot of culture stuff. We've worked on a lot of marching. We've worked on a lot of playing. And everyone is really excited that that is done. And now we're welcoming you.
Yeah.
Yeah. This week is going to be challenging for all of us. It's a lot of hard work. But it's also a lot of really good time spent with each other. We're going to build a lot of bonds together. We're going to work really hard together. And we're also going to laugh a lot together and have a good time. We're going to be really excited as we learn pregame through this week, as we learn the marching style for some of you who come from various different marching styles. We're going to learn some new music and some traditionals. And then we're going to start putting on our first show on the field during this week, all leading up to the first week of classes. So we've got 6 long but fun days together where we'll do all of that work. We're very excited to have you here. Everyone here is here to help support you, and we want to make this feel like the biggest family that you've ever been a part of. So at any point, if you need anything or have any questions, or if you just need someone to listen, or if you need someone to tell you to do your homework, these gentlemen will be happy.
Where are we in? We need a rally out.
Part placement auditions, generally we do those at the start of the semester. We have a bunch of people coming in and we have no idea, we've never heard them play before. We don't know how skilled they are at their instrument. And specifically for trumpet, the higher the note you want to play, it takes a lot of time to build that range. So we hold our auditions to figure out where we're going to put each person. It's not a whether or not you're in the band thing. It's just what notes you're playing while you're playing your music.
Hi, my name is Nadia.
Avery Brewer.
Dombi Nivon, or some people here call me Dom.
This is my second year.
Fourth year.
Third year.
In the Pride of Nine Nation Marching Band.
And I play clarinet.
Trombone.
I play the trumpet.
Last season, I ended up with first part, which is really cool. And I'm hoping to get first part again, but it doesn't really matter to me because, you know, music is music. So I'll play either part as long as, you know, I know that it will sound good. I did practice a little bit, like obviously like summer's a lot, but I practiced about 2 hours. 2 hours in a like spread out in a couple of days. But you know, I spent a lot of time practicing the pieces that I like to play. A lot of the stand tunes that I missed, a lot of the like pieces that I really wanted to get back into and be familiar with again. Yeah.
Hey, I'm Joel. This is my fourth year in the band, also my fourth year at UNC Charlotte. I'm a mechanical engineering major, and I also play a clarinet. Last year, I played a second part, hoping to get first part, but if I play second part this year, I'm fine. You know, it's what I know. I feel pretty confident in it. So, and of course, you know, if I play what I know, I can help out other people. Easy.
I played second part last season, and I would like to get first part. That would be awesome. I'm a little nervous, but, you know, that comes with the challenge.
This season, I've been, just like my other past season, I've been going straight to first trumpet, been trying for first trumpet, so hoping to make first trumpet this time. I practice during the summer every now and then, like maybe once every like 2-3 days, and then I didn't really start practicing every day until like the last week, so I was just trying to get my range in, get my endurance in. I was really just scared about my endurance because, like, when I warm up, my endurance was, like, already whacked out after warm up. But still trying to shoot for first this time.
Music is all about listening, right? So every time that we play, if we're focused only on what we're doing, we're not listening to everybody else. And in marching band, it's even more important because we have so many people on the field. So we've got 171 people on the field every time that we perform. And we all have to do exactly the same thing at exactly the right time, whether that's performing in the style of the music or visually performing or anything like that. And so one of the biggest things that I'm trying to do is increase our awareness of each other. And that comes from like listening to specific things. So in our rehearsals, we talk about, all right, this time we're listening for matching intensity. This time we're listening for matching style or articulation. This time we're listening so that we can match pitch, which is a big one for us today. So increasing the awareness both musically and visually. And then also allowing students to think about what is the style of this music and how does that mean I'm going to play this tenuto or this marcato? And it changes between pieces, right? Like for our halftime, for our first halftime show, we're going to play John Williams music. Well, that's totally different than how we would perform swag surfing in the stands, right? And so making sure that they're taking ownership of performing in the style that we're actually performing in, of the stuff that we're playing. And then I also love that because it just goes back to what we talked about, building community. If we can increase our awareness of each other musically, we can also do that outside of playing and outside of marching. So we're just increasing our awareness and being aware of each other and making sure that we're checking in and how's everything going and hey, it looks like you're a little down today, maybe you need something, and just making sure that we're aware of everything that's going on around us.
And two. appreciate it, and I hope that you're noticing a difference in the way that you're playing, because it's drastically different than it was 3 days ago. So kudos to you. Way to go.
I know you can go faster than that. Set. Check your posture. 5 points of alignment. And this is forward, eight, and close. Forward, eight, and close. Forward. March.
And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Press. Close.
At this position, you will often hear the word check. That means to look down and check your spot, or look around and check your dot. Then you'll hear the word adjust, and that's when you can move. So check. You're moving your head only, and adjust. Now you slide into your spot. You're still at the position of attention. Seeing a lot of big seven steps and then a tiny eight step. Set. Thank you for getting there so fast. And forward. March.
And one.
Adjust. And relax, check it out. Cool, that was much better with our even step size. Same focus. Set.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Prep, close.
Check. Adjust. Relax. All right, everybody, check it out. Great job, you just learned forward march.
I think that people stay motivated when they realize how they're getting better through their hard work. So the first step is getting them to do a little bit of hard work at the beginning, right? And then once they realize how that affects their performance, then they're going to be motivated to do that again and again and again and again, as you know we do in band. And then the other part of it is like we were talking about before with community building. It's really hard to go to work when you don't feel like it's a place where you can be yourself. And so we focus a lot on making sure that everyone can be themselves here and also treat each other in a way that they feel like they can be themselves. So we want people to have a close bond with their section mates, with their bandmates, such that when you're going to work and you're working your butt off and it's 100 degrees outside and you feel like you're going to pass out, you know, you can push through one more rep because you know that your friends on either side of you are doing the same thing.
Good evening, Niner fans, and welcome to the University of North Carolina at Charlotte. Please welcome to the field your 2023 drum majors, Keenan Boswell, Kevin Ramirez Guevara, and Chris Smith, and the 2023 Pride of Niner Nation Marching Band.
Thank you. job this week. I can't stress enough how appreciative I am of the effort that you put in and the dedication that you showed to the band and to each other. It shows a lot of strength of character from every one of you, and I'm really excited to see what we can do this season. Thank you so much.
So this has been the most fun I've had at a band camp my whole 4 years. We learned a lot, we did a lot, and I was just so proud of the band. The performance tonight was something truly special, being my last year marching. We sounded great, we looked good, and we of course had a bunch of our friends and family here, and hoping that this tradition grows even more and more and we invite more and more people each year. And I'm so looking forward to what the Pride of Niner Nation does in the following years.
We'll be right back.